Caesar again, and today we're going to be talking about monster clay. First, I want to start off by referring to this particular packaging. This monster clay was, I don't want to say it's the original one, but basically I bought this one a few years ago, and I was running out of clay, so I decided let's order some more clay. And in doing so, when I placed my order, well, what do you want, the soft, medium, or hard? And I was kind of baffled to go, what do you mean? And she goes, yes, they have the soft, they're medium, and they're hard. We're gonna talk about the solvents I've been using to smooth out. And what I have here, we have the medium, well, shouldn't say the medium, but it's actually comparable to a medium. The original monster clay, I was told that it is the same clay as the one they sell as a medium clay now. So this is what we're dealing with now here. To get to this point, after I sculpted the horse head, I use mineral spirits, which is basically a paint thinner. Get rid of the tool marks, at least most of them. Once that dried out, I switched over to, and this product here, isopropyl muriate. I believe that's how you pronounce it. And I'll get into this more later, and I'll more or less tell you exactly what the product is. But I noticed here, after using it here, even though I used this maybe 12 hours ago, there's still sections of this here that are still wet. Let me get a napkin here and I'll show you what I mean. Under the jaw here, I notice that it hasn't evaporated. It's still somewhat wet, which is good to a degree because it's slow working, which is a good thing because sometimes you don't want a solvent that is too aggressive on your clay. You want it to work slow to make subtle changes. Years ago, I used to use turpentine to kind of help me with the clay, break it down, but turpentine is so toxic. Not only that, it gave me a darn headache. Later, I was told to switch over to the odorless product here, Turpenoid. This product is odorless, Turpenoid, but it's just as toxic as a turpentine, so therefore I stay away from it now. If you're gonna use it, make sure you're wearing some kind of respirator or do it outdoors or in a room that's well ventilated. This product, I will not use again. It is very aggressive on your clay, and if you want to basically have areas of your clay kind of blend, smooth out a lot quicker, use this here, but for the most part, I will stay away from it. Next, what I use most of the time now is mineral spirits here. This happens to be a product I just had in my section there for the oil paintings. And it's, what is the Mona Lisa brand here? Speedball, whatever it's called. Anyhow, it's odorless paint thinner. This is a description for a paint thinner. According to my research, this is the way it reads. Paint thinner is the best since it is half the cost of mineral spirits and basically works the same. Other than the price, the difference between the two solvents are subtle. Both are petroleum-based products. Both can be used to thin oil-based paints and varnishes to clean the brushes. So basically, since your clay is an oil-based clay, it'll work there. Paint thinner is mineral spirits, but less refined form. It contains other types of solvents, which makes it a lot smellier and more volatile. Mineral spirits is not as stinky because it is more refined. It's slightly more effective in smaller quantities than paint thinner. No matter which solvent you choose, make sure you use a well-ventilated space and observe proper safety precautions. So this product I will use first after I'm done sculpting, before I apply the mineral state. And this here, I brush it on depending on the area. I could be a little generous sometimes. Sometimes I go light on it. And what it's doing is basically reacting to the the wax in there, and as it basically dissolves the wax, you're able to brush back and forth and smooth out the hard lines, help you blend. And I brush off most of it, or at least all of it, in a few hours, if not, usually wait 24 hours the next day. The mineral spirits have dissolved, so you're looking at, you're facing a sculpture that's nice and dried. As of now, mineral spirits is my to-go solvent for helping me blend and giving you that nice look, professional look on your sculptures. It does a great job smoothing out things, blending things, getting rid of your tool marks. The great thing about this product is odorless. However, just because it's odorless does not mean there are no fumes there. There's fumes, and just make ensure that you wear the proper respirator and the room is well ventilated. A little information on the terpenoid. The description for the terpenoid is as follows. Terpenoid is a premium turpentine substitute. Evaporates easily at normal temperature. It is thin and colorless and possesses the same painting properties and drying times as turpentine without the strong odor. Many artists use it for their oil colors and varnishes. So in essence, it's turpentine. And just be very careful with this particular product. I recall back in college taking the oil painting class, the instructors would not allow you to bring in turpentine because of the stench, and other students complained because it was so overwhelming, it just gave people headaches. Here's a description for denatured alcohol. Denatured alcohol is also called methylated spirits or denatured rectified spirits. It's an ethanol that has additives to make it poisonous, bad tasting, foul smelling, and nauseating to discourage recreational consumption. Denatured alcohol is used as a solvent and as a fuel for alcohol burners and camping stoves. Not to mention, I believe it's very feasible as far as price when I compare it to this product here. Here we have this product. Yesterday was the first time I used it on that horse head. And today we're going to go ahead and compare this to the denatured alcohol and see if it basically, for the most part, give you the same results. And the description here, which I got the description from the Monsters Clay site, it says, it reads as a very gentle oil-based makeup remover which will remove many types of makeup including packs, prosade, isopropyl, I wonder if that's how you pronounce it, isopropyl, pill, myristate is a fantastic, no odor, non-toxic solvent for monster clay. It tends to dry a little slower than other solvents like mineral spirits, but it dissolves the clay very aggressively and it is a great smoothing agent. Use sparingly with a soft brush and move on to different areas while the solvent evaporates. For polishing monster clay to a glass-like surface, start with a smooth area like the top of the head. Apply a small amount of myristate to a clean paper towel and rub in circular fashion. I used it yesterday, and when I compare it to mineral spirits, this is no way as aggressive as mineral spirits. This took a while to actually start reacting with the clay. Eventually I did get it to the point where I could see it developing a slur. I could see the solvent changing colors, getting to a light color consistency of the clay. But what I did like about it was that it was very subtle changes. And sometimes if you apply a lot of detail on your sculptures, you don't want an aggressive solvent. You don't want to be removing all that detail you took time putting in there. So for that purpose, this was ideal. What I've done here, I've taken my my soft monster clay, and we're going to kind of do an experiment here. On the left-hand side, we'll put the isopropyl myristate, and on the right, the denatured alcohol. And I'm going to go ahead and use their instructions there as far as going sparingly and using a paper towel, if you will, in a circular fashion. I just want to see which one's actually going to give me the better results as far as the glass-like surface. What is, yeah, they go, they refer to it as a glass-like surface. So this is a soft, let's see that one first. It says apply it to your paper towel. In fact, let me zoom, well, the top portion will have it. The lower portion will be the original. And the reason I'm using this here because it basically is asking you to go to a somewhat smooth surface already. So the clay comes to you smooth, so might as well just apply it to what they have. I could see it, the wax breaking down. Let me zoom in and kind of show you here. Let me see, get better lighting. Okay, I placed my camera on manual focus, so it's gonna be focusing on this here alone. And so it'll stop focusing on my hand. Let me make sure of that. Okay. So let's go ahead and do that. This paper towel is a little rough. I did notice on this tub of clay, a lot of the wax came up to the surface here as it was solidifying. I could see it's not the same color as the actual clay, so that may not be fair, but let's try this again. I notice none of the color is transferring over to my napkin here. The paper towel. Let me jump to different clay. This is not fair because I see all the wax on the surface. Okay, we're gonna jump over to their medium clay. It's much better. The quality control in the last tub I had, it was soft. It was very poor. The product shouldn't have gone left the store. I'm referring to the Monster location. Okay, let's get a new napkin. Well, this end here. Yes, okay, they're asking you to apply it to your paper towel. And go in a circular motion. And I'm just checking to see if any of the coloration of the clay is transferring over to my paper towel. And so far, no. To be fair, I did not purchase this, the isopropyl mirror state from Monster Clay. I got it from Amazon, but you would assume it's the same darn product. As you can see, there's very little transfer. I wonder if it's just the friction I'm creating as I rub.
Get better results using my finger. Maybe if I were to use a softer applier, like who wants to be using cotton rags, but I can already see by using my finger, since my finger is very soft, it is nice and clean.
Okay, back to this here. On this side, I'm going to add the denatured alcohol. For now, I have it in this container. We're going to do the same thing. We're going to add. Oh, well, don't leak on me. So I'm to my paper towel here. And do the same thing. I am able to smell the denatured alcohol. Normally I would be using a respirator, but since my last attempt to use a respirator with the mic, it was failed miserably. I could not understand what I was saying via the video, so I was like, oh, I won't do that again. Plus, I have a very small surface I'm working with, so I'm not too concerned. I'm not getting much evaporation here. Same thing here. I don't see any coloration on my towel coming from the clay. And to be fair, I'll use the same technique. It feels really smooth. Let me seal this here. Let's see. I'm using different fingers. Wow, the denatured alcohol is a lot smoother. Interesting. Let me get a close-up, see if you guys can tell the difference. Tell if you guys could tell, but to me, this feels smoother on the right hand side just by not that much of a difference, though. It feels smoother and it also looks glassier. Who would have guessed? We're going to move on to the hard clay and see how that does. Here we have our hard monster clay. We're going to go ahead and do the same thing. Notice I put on some gloves since I didn't want any absorption when using the denatured alcohol. I meant to say absorption into my skin. Oh, interesting. Here, you can see some of the coloration coming over to the paper towel. Getting a better burn here. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and use my glove on this here and see what I get as far as the results. Now the instructions are basically go sparingly. So therefore, they want you to use very, very little of the solvent on your clay. Interesting. Let me jump over to the other one now. Now back to the directions there. They were saying that this product was somewhat aggressive. Well, not somewhat aggressive, but aggressive with the clay. As you can see, it's not really aggressive at all. Same conclusion. The denatured alcohol is giving me better results. It looks glassier. And to be fair to the other one, I'm gonna take off my gloves, use my fingers, and see what I get as far as the finish. Wow, hands down, better results here with the denatured alcohol. Well, let me see if you guys can see that. It's cleaner. It looks like it has a better sheen. It feels smoother. Well, this feels a little, I don't want to say tougher, but it's a little rougher. You don't get the same feel as this one here. So, based on my conclusions, this will probably be, I don't want to say the last time I use it this year, but I'm going to stick to this here to get better results on this. I like that. Nice and clean. And when I compare it to this side here, which did not have any denatured alcohol on it, This is smooth, like ice skating. You come here, I'll say, hit the sidewalk. Here, funny. This feels, I don't want to say tacky, but when I move to this area here, this feels a lot smoother than this here. And this should have been smoother as it would here. This is smooth. Not as smooth as this here, but. Okay. I guess this is like an episode of Mythbusters, huh? Okay, based on the results I got, I'm going to go ahead and apply the denatured alcohol to this piece from what I used yesterday. I used the marriage date on it. So I'm going to apply it in this little cup here. Very little. I don't want too many fumes in the air. And I'm going to place it within this cup here, so I don't spill it. And I'll be using two brushes. They're soft. I'm not sure what kind of brushes they are. Oh, this is a red sable. And this is, I don't know, some kind of generic animal hair. Anyhow, I'm gonna place them in here. Get them nice and saturated with the denatured alcohol. And I'm gonna see what kind of results I get. Interesting. So far what I've done here, I've gone over this side with the denatured alcohol, and I notice I'm getting some kind of, what do I call it? It's almost like a wax film left on top. I wonder if that's the residue from that other product, the mirror state. But I do notice that if I apply it liberally and use my finger to smooth it, I get a nice, clean surface. The only thing is, you don't want to stop midway because you end up leaving your fingerprints, so just guide your finger. I assume after once it dries, come back again and hit it with your finger. It'll get rid of your fingerprints. Because I can see the little grooves of my fingerprints right on the clay surface. Let me rotate this here. Let's see. See if I could adjust the light. A little better. Anyhow, let's apply this here. I'm not sure if it gets, when I hit it with the denatured alcohol, and I get this little debris here happening, almost it looks like wax, and I wonder if I'm getting some kind of reaction from the prior solvent that was here.
but it's just on the surface. As I work it, it comes off. Now, once the horse is put together, one of the final touches, I'm going to hit it with the wash of this denatured alcohol before I send it to the foundry. For that, most likely, if I'm not wearing my respirator, I'm going to go outdoors and apply it there, since I'll be covering the entire piece with the denatured alcohol, and it's going to create such a large surface that we can have a lot of evaporation quickly. And that would not be good for me if I was indoors with it. I'm also going to see about using a latex glove or something when I smooth it. I don't like using my fingers because your skin will absorb the solvent into your body, and that's not good over long periods. Actually, this is pretty good because it does not leave my fingerprints behind. Use latex gloves. In fact, I'm not sure if these are latex gloves, though. You get the idea. Home Depot type of thing. Painter's gloves, I think they refer to them as. In the past, I used those white ones. I think those were called latex gloves. And those, after a while, you could see them just tearing because the solvents would just eat into them. Oh, this works well. Nice and smooth. Much, much better than just using your hands without gloves. You could just feel how smooth it glides through the clay. So I seem to be a little liberal with the denatured alcohol. Otherwise, if you give it time to evaporate, you start feeling the tackiness. That's it for now.